Commerce meeting, we took a vote and we reviewed all the articles, 2 through 11, and looked at all the pros and cons of them, and unanimously opposed the articles. And right now I'd like to talk a little bit about Article 2, but in the effort of time, talk about a few others here as well. So I won't be able to every single article. But Article 2, the way it's set up right now is that there, like he said, there's a 5-person committee, subcommittee. And we feel that's certainly enough voices from both committees to give a full review of the project. By having both committees fully review the project, the design committee and the historical committee, that just adds more time and conflict. So when you've got the historical committee making their opinions and the design committee, you have two people competing with their opinions. And that just adds more time and more cost to the process. And therefore, it slows down the process of getting developed in town and it adds more time. So it's not encouraging development in the center of town, it just adds more bureaucracy to the whole process. So that's something that we oppose formally from the Chamber of Commerce. I'd like to address a couple others here as well at the same time. Article 4. By lowering the threshold for the site plan review from 15,000 feet to 7,500 feet. 15,000 feet, I mean, 7,500 feet is a pretty small lot. So essentially, you're going to be requiring every project to have a full site plan review. The full site plan review is the historic commission, the design review plan, the design review committee, the planning board, and which therefore is reviewing the Board of Appeals. So you have four different committees, pretty much giving their separate conflicting opinions on every single project. That adds a lot of time, a lot of money to the process. Makes it very cumbersome to build in town. So you're in 3 to 6 months of the process, and therefore a lot of cost. It's not really encouraging development in town to make it easy for people to build in town. Article 5 talks about the as of right way, and this is from 45 to 40 feet. Essentially, that would require anything less than 3 stories. So 2-story buildings is the only thing that can be as of right to build. A 3-story building would need to have approval by the committee, and it requires a special permit to get any over 2 stories. Once again, that's also a bit burdensome and a lot of bureaucracy to get a basic project built. Article 7 and 8, the big thing in here is the elevator penthouse. The elevator penthouse essentially is a space above the elevator that projects above the roof. That's roughly about 5 feet above the roof for the elevator to function the building. So therefore, you can only have an elevator in a 2-story building without being approved with a special permit. So that is very burdensome as well. And so that is something that we oppose. It pretty much requires any over 2-story building to have a special review for a special permit. Excuse me, brought my water flask. All right. And Articles 9, 10, 11 show that all rooftop equipment be shown on the preliminary documents for approval. So essentially, you have a sketch of a building of what it's going to look like to the neighborhood, how it's going to impact the neighborhood, but you have to have all the equipment that's atop the roof in place for approval process. To do that, it requires a full mechanical design of the building, which therefore, if any of you have done any quoting, you just can't kind of have an idea or ballpark. You have to have the building pretty much done and built, which requires tens of thousands of dollars and a lot more time to have that done. So it's very burdensome for anyone to come up with a proposal for a project, which might not even get approved. So by having that approval for the rooftop, to have it, all the rooftop equipment, once again, it's another article. It's Articles 9, 10, 11. That another bureaucracy, and this is another thing that adds more